got a seawall here, and we've seen the sand 6 foot below the seawall.
From cleaning our beaches to building them up, Collier County tells NBC2 they want their beaches to be able to resist a 100-year storm. But is it worth the $30 million price tag? NBC2's Gabrielle Dawkins is live at Park Shore Beach in Collier County.
As my homeowners here are all for it, not only to protect their homes, but to protect our beaches. Before Walt Harbor bought this house, he saw pictures of it after a huge storm.
Windows blowed out, and when we redid it, we got the shells out of the walls inside the house.
The added features surrounding his house protects it from potential future damages.
This is the seawall. When the water comes up, it takes the water around the house.
The county wants to take steps to prevent catastrophic damages to homes near the coast.
We're going to look and see if we could design to resist a 100-year storm.
They are taking a look at four beaches: Vanderbilt, Park Shore, Naples Beach, and Marco Island Beach. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers will cover 65% of the $30 million cost. The remaining money will come from tourist development revenue.
Well, the prettier it is, the more people they get here, and the more people they get here, the more taxes they get to do things like this.
When the county first visited the idea, they were looking at making the beaches 50 feet wider and about 2 to 3 feet taller. But now they are rethinking just how wide and tall they plan to make it.
We will look to resist or to build the beach as wide as we can based on environmental conditions.
We need the sand.
Homeowners say they have no plans on moving out of this Southwest Florida paradise.
Sort of like it's heaven's waiting room. We were really concerned this past year, and it's just one of those chances you got to take.
Now, the Army Corps of Engineers will present their plan in January of 2020. McAlpin says it will take about 5 years to get this project up and going. In Naples, Gabrielle Dawkins, NBC2.